what is HYPP? And I also want to give Gabby credit. This user has previously asked a question about what fruits and vegetables are okay to feed your horse, which is one of your favorites.
No, that was it was not. That was a tough one.
But you got to talk about prunes.
Oh, I did.
Yeah.
All right.
So
okay.
there's some upside in there for you.
HYPP.
Yeah.
So what it stands for is hyperkalemic periodic paralysis.
Obviously.
We can break down each word. So hyperkalemic, kalemia refers to potassium,
mm-hmm.
obviously.
And it's a K on the periodic table.
Right.
There you go.
And so hyperkalemia means that excessive potassium in the blood. And then periodic just means occasional,
sometimes.
And paralysis, that's a little bit of a scary word, but that's what horses do when they have this disease, this genetic disease, is they occasionally have muscle tremors and paralysis and fasciculations. Just trying to give hard words to spell.
Yep, for Nels to put on
the screen. Right. So it's in quarter horses and quarter horse crosses. So like Appaloosas and Paints, kind of the stock horse breeds.
Mm-hmm.
And it all comes from a gene from a horse named Impressive that was born in the 60s. And now the AQHA, the American Quarter Horse Association, requires foals that have Impressive in their pedigree to be tested, and then they can only be registered if they're not double positive for this, which would be called homozygous. If you have one copy of the gene, then you're heterozygous. Those foals can be registered. Two copies of the gene, you can't. And two copies means you're quite likely to develop this, and it's going to be severe. This can actually be a fatal disease, but the severe presentation of this is they don't just have the muscle tremors and the shakes and the sweating and their third eyelid prolapses, or you'll see it. They can actually go down, and they can stop breathing, or their heart can stop.
Mm-hmm. Because those are both muscles.
Right, and what that also means is these horses can be dangerous to be around.
Mm-hmm.
So you want to be careful if you know you have one. That if you don't know if you have one, but you could because you have a quarter horse and there is Impressive in the pedigree, the testing is super easy. It's done at UC Davis, the University of California, Davis. They have the lab. And all you have to do is send in about 20 to 30 mane or tail hairs pulled out from the root. So you don't cut them, you pull them out from the root. And the cool thing is, and I just went there, they have videos that show you how to do this.
Hmm.
They also have the test kit that has the forms and an envelope that you lay the hairs in, mailed away, takes about 2 weeks, done. So if there's a chance your horse could have this, you need to know for safety reasons. And also there's medications that your horse can be on to sort of their potassium clearing, so they get rid of extra potassium. Hay has a lot of potassium in it.
Mm-hmm.
Alfalfa hay in particular. Other things that have potassium, because you want your horse's diet to be low in potassium. That's
for these horses.
For HYPP horses.
Okay.
That's sort of the main prevention tool. So molasses, things that have molasses should not be given to HYPP horses. You have to be careful with the electrolytes.
Mm-hmm.
Horses need salt. And so with these guys, I would give plain, pure salt and not a well-rounded or balanced electrolyte.
Because
it's
potassium.
It's going to have potassium in it, yeah. Kelp is not a good thing. Soybeans have a lot of potassium, so you want to stay away from those. Good things to have, and this is surprising and sort of contrary to what we've always said, grains.
Hmm.
Oats, corn, barley.
Whole grains. Okay.
Are very low in potassium. So these horses can have grain meals. And then the thing that experts recommend is feeding small meals frequently. Because the whole diet should be less than about 1-1.5% potassium, and your vet and your nutritionist or feed XL can help you with that. But each meal should have no more than about 33 grams of potassium. So one of the ways you do that is to feed small meals frequently.
Mm-hmm.
Pasture, again, not something, it's something we recommend, but often with a muzzle, you know, because of sugar problems. But grass pasture for these horses is excellent because the water content of the pasture and how slowly they like meander through pasture and eat keeps the potassium from climbing sky high.
As opposed to hay, which is dry and they can eat a whole bunch at
almost
once.
Almost concentrated, yeah. Yeah, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
It was a big question, but I think we got a really well-rounded
answer.
Huge question.
If you want to know more about it, go to UC Davis and read. And also AQHA has some wonderful reading materials and documents you can download about it, because they are the group that knows the most about it.
Yeah. We'll try to include links to those that you referenced in the video descriptions so that you guys can get right to them from there.
Great.
And then, of course, I know you've answered some HYPP questions, and we have some articles on it in our
Horse
Health Library, too.
Yep.
So we'll link to those as well.
We've got resources, too. Yep.